What's up, everybody? I've been getting a lot of messages to do a Saw 5 review, so yeah, here I am. I saw the film on Friday night, couldn't do the review, then I was real tired, so here I am. Alright, Saw. Always been a Saw fan. I never was a fan of horror films and gore, but I always loved the Saw series because it's more of a psychological horror thriller. Other horror films, you know, it's just some dude slashing teenagers up and some spiritual entity just haunting people. And, you know, this one sets itself apart from other horror films. So, you know, I love this series. I own them all on DVD. You know, I appreciate these films a lot. So, Saw 5. Saw 5 has two plots in it. The main plot is with Detective Hoffman, Jigsaw, and Peter Strom. That's the main plot of the movie. That's where all the juice is. You know, that's what you want to see. Then there's this other plot going on with these five strangers going through a series of tests and games. And really, they're just not they're not relevant to the movie at all. I mean, I don't know why they were in. It's just sort of like sort of a excuse to put traps in the movie, I guess. But yeah, let me just say that this is probably the weakest of the whole series. And I'm going to tell you why. Let's just start with the weaknesses of the film. Had horrible acting. And I'm not talking about Tobin Bell, who was always great as Jigsaw. Costas Mandaloris Hoffman was great. Betsy Russell as Jill. She wasn't in the movie as much, but she really delivered on this one scene. And Scott Patterson as Agent Strom, you know, he's great. Everybody else really just needs to go back and learn a few things about acting, because they really were hard to watch. Another weakness of the film, there is less Jigsaw in this film than any other Saw movie. And I'm talking about maybe he shows up for probably 10 minutes. Like, they probably handed Tobin Bell a script that was like 5 pages long or something like that, because he was only in here for like 10 minutes. And that's a disappointment, because this is Saw. I want to learn more about Jigsaw's perspective, his origin, and just learn more about the character. His character intrigues me a lot, the way Tobin Bell portrays it. And, you know, Saw 4, I know he died in Saw 3, but Saw 4 managed to put him in through a lot of flashbacks. So I was disappointed there wasn't more flashbacks with Jigsaw in them. Another weakness of the film was probably the twist. I love the twists in these movies. I love them. But Saw 5 really wasn't a shocker. It was pretty predictable. Like, you can't predict all of it. I'm not going to say, like, I knew the whole thing, but there are parts of it you could predict. And then when they go through the montage sort of at the end with the Saw music playing, it was, like, 30 seconds long. Like, it really didn't need to explain much. It wasn't much of a twist at all, you know? It was, like, whatever. Like, it was just okay. So I was really disappointed with the twist, because I love the twist. You know, I always go to see these movies for the twist and the plot. Another weakness of the film was probably just the direction. Like, David Hackle is the director for Saw 5. He was the production designer for Saw 1, 2, I mean, excuse me, he was production designer for Saw 2, 3, and 4. So I had faith in David Hackle, but, I mean, directing's just not his thing. I didn't like the direction he took with this movie, so yeah, it was a bit of a disappointment. I wish James Wan or Bousman came back and directed this one. Yeah, so those are the weaknesses of the film. The good parts about the movie, okay, let me go through the good parts. Strong points was just the pacing of the film. The pacing of the film is important, because Saw 4 went so fast, they threw everything at you so quickly that when the twist came, you're like, what the hell just happened? You didn't understand what the hell just happened when you're going through that montage. So Saw 5 has a good pace to it, so you understand the twist at the end. You understand everything that happens. You don't have to watch it more than once or read up on it. You just know what happens. Another good point was that while the twist was weak, it's still cool to see how the antagonist, I'm not going to mention any names here, how the antagonist, just everything happened the way they wanted it to. Each Saw film, you see Jigsaw, like, owning everybody else. Like, you know, he's good at seeing what the human mind will do in a certain situation, and that's exactly what happens in this one. The antagonist sees what's going to happen, and, you know, it happens. So, I mean, he owns everybody. So in that aspect, it was good. Another good aspect of the film, it answered a lot of questions tracing back to, like, Saw 1. And it also brought up a lot of new questions, and that's what a Saw film does. It should answer a whole bunch of questions, but it should also bring up some new ones. Except for Saw 6. Saw 6 has to answer everything. I'm gonna be pissed off. But yeah, on that respect, it delivered. What else was good about this film? Oh yeah, the five people in the traps, while they were irrelevant, they learned something near the end of the game. And they were like, oh man, we fucked up. And it was pretty funny to see their reaction to it. So, you know, overall, that's all that's good about the movie. There are more negatives, I guess, in a way, about the movie. This is the worst in the series. But while it is the worst in the series, I think it is still a necessary installment. I think it bridges the gap between 4 and 6. It's more informative, and it's a necessary installment, because I think without 5, I don't think you can have 6. So, you know, average moviegoers won't like this. Stay away from it. I mean, if you're just here to see the traps and the blood and the gore, you'll get it. I mean, there are a lot of cool traps, a lot of gore. So you'll get that if that's all you see. But if you're a genuine Saw fan, a hardcore Saw fan, and you want to see how the story plays out, you're going to be a little disappointed with this one. I mean, go check it out matinee. Don't go at night like I did and pay $10.50 a ticket to watch this. You know, I should have gone matinee. So yeah, it's an average film. It's okay, the worst in the series. But I mean, compared to other horror films, other series that go up to 5, you know, this one's, you know, it's still doing its thing. So hopefully Saw 6, you know, will be a little bit better and they take a better direction with this. I'm not as optimistic about Saw 6 now, but I'm still gonna see it opening night. So yeah, overall, I'd give Saw 5 a 7 out of 10. Yeah, it's just average. So there you go. This was the non-spoiler review part of it. So if you have not seen Saw 5, right now is the time that you got to click out and, you know, go see the movie or do something and come back and listen to the rest of it, because I'm going to talk about some spoilers now. All right, hopefully you've seen Saw 5, because I'm going to talk about some spoilers. The twist. I thought the twist was stupid because it really didn't pertain to the story at all. It was just like telling Strom, like, hey, you should have listened to me. Because at the beginning, you know, he finds that tape that says, don't continue this investigation, stay in that room and you'll be fine. He didn't listen. He went on and he got put in that trap, but, you know, he survived. And then he gets warned again in the second time, you know, get in this glass box, you know, trust me, your life will be spared. And, you know, this dude must be retarded or something, and he doesn't get in the glass box. You know, the twist is basically, hey, you should have listened to me. Now, all signs to the Jigsaw investigation point to you as a suspect, so you're screwed and you're dead. You know, it's not, I mean, that's what it is. It's basically, hey, you should have listened to me. And to me, that's pretty dumb. Like, the other films was like, you know, the first one, like, you didn't expect Jigsaw to be in the middle of the room alive. You didn't, in the second one, you didn't expect Daniel to be right next to Eric Matthews, and all he had to do was talk to Jigsaw. In the third one, you didn't expect that game to be for Amanda. And in the fourth one, you didn't expect that Rick just had to not do anything to save Eric. I mean, those were all like wow shocker moments. And this one's like, hey, you should have listened to me. We all know that you gotta listen to Jigsaw. I mean, we're not retarded either, you know. Listen to the dude and you'll live. And in that respect, it was stupid. Also, I'm curious about that note left on Hoffman's desk. It says, I know who you are. Me and my brother came up with the theory that Jill wrote that because there's a flashback that, you know, Jigsaw said, you know, I got evidence on you. He's basically blackmailing Hoffman, you know, and I think that Jigsaw left the evidence in that box that he gave to Jill in his will. So, you know, probably Jill wrote that. She knows that Hoffman's in it. That's just a theory. You know, this theory's been floating around already, so yeah. Other spoilers, I don't think there are any other spoilers, I mean, that I want to talk about. I mean, it's cool, like, how Hoffman has been helping Jigsaw since Saw 1. That's pretty cool and all that. But yeah, there's no other spoilers I want to talk about, so hopefully Saw 6 will have a super cool ending, you know, wrap everything up nicely, no questions left. So yeah, until next Halloween, guys, take care.